What's going on, guys? Andrew Piluk Hockey here, back again with another video. Today I wanted to kind of have a discussion, and you guys are probably looking at the title. I'm not trying to cause any chaos or start something. It's more of really a question I'm kind of asking myself. Is Sheldon Keefe kind of calling out William Nylander? And why is this happening? Why is this a thing? Why are we still talking about William Nylander as if it's sort of a problem, and the narrative around him, like, why is it still the, oh, he disappears and this, that, and the other? I could do this for a few different players, and this video is not me trying to compare Nylander to other players, but a lot of the guys on this team that get paid more money, or, you know, guys on this team that aren't performing who should be performing, like, why is it that Nylander is the guy that is consistently being called out? So, and also talked about, in a bit of a negative light in the media. I'm just a little bit confused. This is a video of me just kind of ranting to you guys, and I want to hear your response to this. And again, this isn't me directly saying that Nylander is being called out. I'm literally questioning if this is like a mini call out, and if there's anything to this, and why it consistently happens, because it happens, it seems like once every few months in the season that this happens. So if you are new here, make sure to like this video and subscribe. I'd really appreciate it. Also, enjoy the game tonight. There's going to be a game, but here's the reason why I'm making this video. So the other day, the lines for November 15th came out yesterday. Richie, Matthews, Marner, Kerfoot, Tavares, Nylander. So the lines are right back to how they were before. And in the last nine games, I believe the Leafs are what, on like that 8-1 tear or something like that? Or they're just playing really well. They've been consistently winning games. Matthews and Nylander are doing fine. Marner has been playing better. Tavares has been good. And then there's more and more things that have come out and more information that I've been trying to put together to kind of make sense of all this. Because then this came out. Sheldon Keefe on what gets William Nylander, and he, the player, came to him making it clear that he needs a push every now and then. So this is what Sheldon Keefe said. I think it's just one of those things where part of it comes naturally to some guys, that they are just naturally competitive and bring it all the time. Some guys, they need prodding. They need to be pushed. The situation in the games brings that out of them. Sometimes the coach brings that out of them. Sometimes themselves internally bring it. We've talked to Will a number of times, and he's made it very clear to me that he's a guy that wants to be pushed and challenged and feels that he needs that. So at times, that's the way it's going to go for him. I think what we've always seen from Will is that at times a dominant player, as good or better than anybody on the ice, and has carried us through some tough patches and produced at a high level. And at other times, it's not as good. I think that what we're trying to find with Will and all of our players is that the nature of that is the nature of that. This is really like all over the place. No offense to David Alter. I know it's tough. You got to get it out right away. But some of this I just don't understand. The difference between your best and worst is not a massive gap, and I think that's really important as a player. But it's not an easy thing to get to, but I certainly believe that William, through the last year and parts of last season and parts of this season, is starting to close that gap. Let me remind you guys, first of all, it's good that Nylander says that it's good to be pushed every once in a while, but Nylander led the Leafs in points in the playoffs last year with over a point per game, and he started off this season leading the team in points, and he's I believe just 1 point under a point per game, and we'll look at that. But why is it consistently that when the media brings up, or whenever something comes out with Sheldon Keefe, somehow there's never any other player that really takes that heat in terms of the big name guys? Matthews, Marner, Tavares, none of these guys ever really get the, oh, well, they haven't really shown much. Marner looked like he wasn't even on the team for the first few games. And again, I'm not trying to compare it. I love Mitch Marner. I'm so happy that he's playing better. But this even happened last year when there was times where maybe Johnny T wasn't playing so good, or maybe Matthews wasn't really doing anything. But last year, we can say he pretty much played good every game. But Marner, you know, there was times in the playoffs and this, that, and the other where he could have easily been called out in the same way. And let me remind you, in the last game, Nylander was actually benched for a few shifts. We're not seeing Marner get benched. We're not seeing Tavares get benched. We're not seeing Matthews get benched. We're only seeing Nylander get benched in times like this. And I don't understand why Sheldon Keefe is only bringing Nylander up in the media. Like, why is this the only player that gets talked about? And one thing I'll bring up as well. Yesterday, Sportsnet 590, The Fan, had this as a topic where they're saying he shows you these flashes of brilliance and extra effort. And then when it's not there for two games after that, you're going, where did it go? Jim Ralph and Kipper and JT Bourne are talking about this. Again, all respect to Sportsnet. I'd love to work there. But why is this a discussion? Why is William Nylander a discussion on this show and like not doing certain things and not being able to play to the top of his ability and this, that, and the other? There's so many other storylines. There's so many other players. There's so many different things that could be talked about. And this is still a topic when the guy has, what, 15 points in 16 games and then was over a point per game in the playoffs for the Leafs last year. He's shown more effort than most of this team on lots of occasions. So again, I'm not really sure where this is coming from. So looking at the numbers to start the year, Tavares 15-15, Nylander 15-16, Marner's picked it up 14-16, Matthews 12-13, Kerfoot even 10-16, Riley 10-16, Bunting 7-16. Like, we're the Leafs are starting to put together some pretty good numbers. They're starting to put together a pretty good season. And again, William Nylander is at the top here, getting paid significantly less money than somebody who wasn't showing up in some of the games. Because let's remember, Marner went on a bit of a tear lately and started putting up multiple point games. At the beginning of the season, it wasn't there. Same thing with John Tavares. There was some parts where I'm like, that's not really there. Even Matthews, you're kind of going, damn, Matthews, come on, man, pick it up a little bit. And again, these guys, I'll defend them till the cows come home. I'll defend Marner, I'll defend Tavares, Matthews, whoever it is. I love this team. As a fan, I get frustrated when it's like, how is this still a thing? How are we still talking about Nylander not showing up for some games? And let's be honest, it does happen. It does. Nylander has some bad games, but he's performing the way he's supposed to. Marner has some bad games, but guess what? He's picking it up. He's performing how he's supposed to. Tavares, same thing. Matthew, same thing. But those two usually play a little bit better than everybody else most nights. Why is this still a thing? I don't get it. So I also wanted to look at some other things here. If we're talking even strength points, that's what I wanted to bring up, okay? So on even strength, time on ice, Matthews is getting more ice time. Tavares is, Marner is. Nylander's the fourth guy there by a shift, basically. But with Matthews, it's quite a big difference, right? And now let me just reset this. Okay. And then time on ice total, again, Nylander is underneath these guys because they get more shorthanded time and everything else like that, okay? So even strength points, Nylander is performing at even strength, okay? Even strength assists, Nylander's still performing. Even strength goals, Nylander is still performing. I'm struggling to see where Nylander needs to be called out for maybe not playing the best here, maybe taking some time off. Could he be even better? Maybe. But why is this something that needs to come out? If he's telling you that he wants to be pushed a little bit, I don't think he means in the media. I really don't think that's what it means. And this whole gripe of like picking on one certain guy reminds me of when Phil Kessel played for the Maple Leafs. Fans, the media, coaching, whatever it was, he's uncoachable. Man, well, kiss his cup rings because he's got two of them. Phil Kessel is one of the most misunderstood players in the history of this game. I will stand by that. He put up amazing numbers on terrible teams. The Leaf teams that he played for were brutal. 55 points in 70 games, 64-82, 82-82, including 30 goal seasons all over the map, 52-48, 80-82, 61-82. And then look, he goes to Pittsburgh and plays amazing again because he's playing with more talented guys. Look at this, minus 34. How bad does that team have to be for him to be a minus 34? He never really played with true first-line line mates. He was always put with other guys that couldn't really perform. Nylander's playing with guys that can perform. He's performing. And yeah, sure, he has some bad nights, but everybody does. Why is it still the Nylander this, Nylander that? I will not understand. And as a fan, and even not just like as a fan, just in general, there's other players on this team that had bad games and big stretches that were not benched and were not called out. I'm puzzled. So I did this video to ask you if I'm nuts. Let me know what you guys think. I'll see you guys in the next video. Peace.